Today we want to pray for the grace to love those who don't love us. You know, Jesus said to love your enemies, to pray for those who despitefully use you. You know what I mean? There are instances in our lives when we are fully aware that people that we deal with do not like us. And it's not easy to love somebody who you know hates your own shadow. You know, they just can't stand you. They talk about you, they mistreat you, they'll lie on you, they'll take advantage of you, they'll use you and abuse you. And the Lord said, we're supposed to love those people. You know what I mean? We need grace to do that. And when you consider, you know, that he said, if you love those who love you, you know, what thank have you? What credit is that to you to love those who love you? Because sinners do the same, he said. And if you only salute your brethren and don't salute others, you know, that's no credit to you either, because the people in the world do the same thing. So I tell you, my brother and sister, when we understand that to do what God requires of us is more than we are capable of sometimes, and so we need grace to help us in our time of need. Because what your natural instinct is that when that joker hits you, to hit him back. You know, if he slap you, and we know we're supposed to turn the other cheek, but what happens after you done turn the cheek? There are no more cheeks to turn, so you slap back. I'll just come to tell you today that God loves those who don't love him. And we're supposed to be imitators of God. We're not just to, you know, kiss up to people and love on people who kiss up and love on us. You're supposed to be able to do it, or we should do it, to those who don't love us at all. And so I want to believe God for you today, as well as myself in prayer, that God would give us that grace that will enable us to love somebody who you know can't stand you. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we are asking you this morning to give us grace to help us in our time of need. And we need to be able to love those who we know don't love us. So I pray that your mercy will extend towards us so that we will not be as the sinners are, who only love those who love them, but that we can wish them well and love them as we love ourselves, to wish for them what we would wish for ourselves, that they would have all that they need. Their needs would be supplied. They will not be broke, busted, and disgusted. I pray that when they go to buy groceries, they don't have to calculate and count whether or not they could buy bread. I pray that they're not worried or disturbed by the resources not enough or sufficient to pay their mortgages, to pay their car notes, to pay their rent, or whatever the bills are, because you've made it so for us that we don't have to worry about those things, but can give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of your word. Let them have the liberty to be able to just worship you without worrying about what they're going to eat and what they're going to drink and what they're going to wear and where they're going to live. This is what I'm asking for the enemies who can't stand me and who can't stand your people. We believe for you to be able to love them just as we are loved by you. For while we were yet sinners, Christ died for the ungodly. And how much more for those now who are sons and daughters by inheritance and adoption by the Spirit through faith. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. This is Ken. I'm your partner in prayer, God's prophetic intercessor, letting you know something good always happens when we pray.